my friends, welcome to the Bavarian Outback. This is my channel where I do some crafts and some traditional things. Sometimes I cook a little bit and sometimes I just sit on my campfire and enjoy the silence. In this episode we will build a little bird feeder, a little birdhouse, and completely out of stuff you will find in your garage or in your shed or in your garden. A lot of scrap material, stuff you normally would throw away. That's what it is in this episode. Have fun and enjoy the build. Before we start, let's prepare all the materials and all the tools we need so that we have it in the reach. For me, it's also the first time that I use this old wooden chair and building a birdhouse out of it. So let's check for this little experiment and find out if it's working at the end. First of all, we need an old chair. An old wooden chair. This is a chair out of oak tree, so it's a very, very hard wood. And the good thing is that we can use this inner square that the bird feed is not falling out of the birdhouse in the end. That's perfect, so we don't have to build the inner support. And it's open on one side. That's great, because there you can put the feed in and clean the house. The next thing is we have to cut the legs, because we want to have a little roof which is a little bit narrow, so it looks a little bit like an old Bavarian mountain shed. Of course, we will also build the roof out of scrap material. Here I have some really old window blinds. Of course, we will tune them a little bit and make them a little more nice. I think this old patina will fit perfectly on our old Bavarian off-grid birdhouse.
Ich hoffe, das taugt euch.
I hope you like the setup, so enjoy the video. So, what do we need? We need a screwdriver, completely charged, especially when it's cold outside. Then we need a jigsaw, a very sharp one. Yes. Then we need a saw. I prefer this little Japanese saw, because it's very precise and you can cut very, very easy and of course precisely. I really like this saw. There is nothing more precise and I really, really love cutting with this saw. You can cut everything with the jigsaw, but I really have fun cutting it with this saw. Then you need some pot drills. I don't know the size of the final holes, so I have a bunch of them, so we are prepared. Then we need some normal drills, and then we need some screws. Long ones and shorter ones. Yeah, so now we have every color, yellow, green, blue, orange. So I think we are prepared and we can start.
So, yeah, fangen wir an.
The first thing we do is we cut off the backrest of this chair. Then we will cut the legs of this chair for the perfect roof size. Now I bring the camera a little bit closer so that you can see everything. Then we take the saw, perfect parallel, and cut off the backrest.
Parallel zur Bodenplatte werden wir jetzt dieses Teil hier wegsägen.
Here you can see why I love this saw so much. It goes so fast and it cuts so exactly. There is no saw which is better like this one. I can absolutely recommend this saw. I cannot tell you the name of the manufacturer. It says Han something, Han Solo maybe. I don't know. So let's go for the next one.
So, fertig.
Ready
ist
with
der
the
erste
first
Teil
part of the bird feeder.
Das ging jetzt halt mal viel
this went
schneller,
really quick.
Schauen wir mal, vielleicht fällt uns ja mit dem Teil hier.
Maybe later we have any idea what we can do with this part. Looks interesting. Looks like a wooden Mandalorian mask or something.
Schaut ein bisschen nach einer Mandalorian Maske aus, ha? Huh? Tja,
next video, wooden Mandalorian mask build.
Nächsten Video. Gut, weiter im Vogelhäuschen-Thema. Also nächstes geht's
next part
hier
is
weiter.
Cutting down the legs for
das heißt,
the
Dach
roof.
Reinmachen.
We need a perfect angle, so maybe we should just try and take a quick look how it could look like, not too high and not too narrow, and we have to find exactly the middle, and then we will start cutting it down.
So läuft. Dafür werden wir die hier ein bisschen kürzen. Dann nehmen wir uns jetzt hier mal ein Referenzmaß.
I think this would be a nice angle, so it looks like a shed in the mountains.
Dass das hier auf jeden Fall über die Ränder drüber steht, damit da kein Wasser reinkommt. Und das Dach ziehen auch relativ tief runter, dass die Vögel da zwar reinkommen, aber dass es ein bisschen katzensicher ist
und auch extrem windgeschützt. Das ist natürlich wichtig für Vogelhäuschen.
Da haben wir schon eine schöne Fläche
für das Vogelfutter.
So it's safe and it's
for the wind and not so easy to blow it out. The next good thing is, with a little broom, you can easily swipe out all the rest of the bird feed. Next, we need two pieces of wood that can help us making the angle for the roof. So we put them here and check what angle for the roof would be a really nice one. So the measurements between here and here must be bigger than the measurements between the legs of this old chair, so that it can fit right between here and here. So we are going to look for a useful angle, so that it will fit together perfectly in the end.
Damit es vernünftig und schön ausschaut.
First of all, we shorten the legs to a perfect length, so that the roof will fit in a perfect angle on this sub-construction.
Naja, so lang werden wir es machen.
I'm going to cut it at a size of 22 centimeters, which are about 9 inches. So that means that the legs of this chair are 35 centimeters distance, and that's the same distance we need for the bottom side of the roof plate. And as I mentioned before, we need a little bit more distance, so we take not the 35, we take the 40 centimeters. Then you have to mark the middle, that's 20, and on top we need also a little mark that we can place the perfect angle.
Da ist dann praktisch der Giebel.
And now we have this little mark here for the middle of the roof, and now we can cut it out perfectly.
Dass das dann auch passt. Das zeichnen wir uns jetzt hier schnell an.
Now we take this big marker. We can use this big one because it's the inside of the roof, so you won't see this line. And then we just mark both sides of the roof. Then we cut along these lines.
Machen da drüben den sauberen Strich her. So. Und schon haben wir einen Giebel fertig.
Da hier so here we make a little cross, das heißt, so that we know it's a waste material and it's not the roof, so that we don't mix it up later, because that would be a problem. So just to make sure that we have two exactly same sizes on the left and on the right side, we measure these things, 22,5, so then we know the angle is perfect.
Das ist auf jeden Fall ein gleichschenkliges Dreieck geworden.
So the next step is we have to mark these legs from the chair, because we want to shorten it down, that we get a really cool roof, like an old Bavarian shed. And now we take the same marker and then we just check that the angle is perfect and that the lengths of all the legs are the same. So we take the outside from the leg on all sides, the outside, because it's getting a little bit of an angle. That's why we take the outside, and on the outside it's a little bit shorter, and on the inside it's a little bit longer, because we have the same angle like we use on the roof plates.
Und von der Außenstelle 19 cm runter messen und hier zeichnen wir uns dann die 19 cm an jedem Fuß an und genau da sägen wir es ab. Und wenn ihr das so richtig schön perfekt machen wollt, dann sägt er die natürlich auch so schräg ab. So. Das heißt, 19 cm höchste Stelle ist dann praktisch die tiefste Stelle an unserem Fuß, weil es ja innen drinnen nach oben geht. Das heißt, wir zeichnen uns die tiefste Stelle an und von der tiefsten Stelle machen wir dann genau in dem gleichen Winkel wie unser Dach, machen wir dann einen richtig schönen Schnitt und dann kriegen wir auch ein richtig schönes.
So just to make sure, measure always twice, because better a little bit too long than a little bit too short.
So, wenn er das
because you always can cut it shorter, but you never can cut it longer.
Dann nehmt ihr den genau vor euch und dann zeichnet ihr hier schon mal die Dachschräge.
So we also mark the angle of the roof on these four legs. Take it in front of you. Right in the middle, and then you paint exactly the line on the leg that you know how to cut.
Von oben nach unten anfangs zu schneiden. Wenn es in der Mitte anfangs mit 19 cm, werden sie natürlich alle unterschiedlich hoch. Kann man danach.
The exacter you paint the markings, the less you have to do later in cutting or putting it on a perfect angle.
So schaut das jetzt aus.
That's how it looks now. That's the same. Angle like the piece of wood for the roof side that we cut it right before. You see, that was really fast. So we take the next one. As you know, I love these Chinese or Japanese saws, because they work itself into the material. You just have to hold it very, very easily and then let it go and it cuts so perfectly. I really love to work with this little tool.
Dann säge ich jetzt ab und dann sehen wir uns gleich wieder.
So let's finish the last three legs. It walks through the oak wood like butter.
Und fertig.
So the base plate is ready and now we go for the next part.
Das wird ein richtig schönes Vogelhäuschen. Für alle, die sich immer noch nicht recht viel vorstellen können.
For a better imagination, I just show you how I want to have the roof. That's the way it will look when we finish it.
Sache.
That will become a beautiful little birdhouse. My fingers start getting really cold, so let's do the next steps with the jigsaw. The cool thing with these things is, we take this one, put it the other way around, make a little mark, and then we have to do one cut less, and we have the exact same piece a second time, with the perfect angle that we need.
Passt hier richtig schön rein. Perfekt, genau der richtige Giebel. Lieber noch einmal mehr
always check
bevor man
two times, because if you don't, maybe you have two wrong parts.
Perfekt. Das Teil mit
as
dem
you
Kreuzel,
see, what a good idea it was to mark the wrong one with the cross, so we don't mix it up. Because now it looks on the first sight exactly like the other one, but it has a completely different angle. Now we are going to cut a little hole in this part of wood, because then it looks a little bit like a nice little cute window.
Oder ein bisschen größer, ein bisschen kleiner.
You can make it a little bit bigger or a little bit smaller, but I think this one is the perfect size for our little bird feeder.
Vogelhäuschen. Genau die nehmen wir her. Die Teile kennst du ja, diese Multi-Dinger, da hackelt man das einfach ein.
I think you know these little multi-tools. You can click it in here in the rotating direction, so it can't come out, and then you can use it for every size.
Die ihr auch sehen wollt, weil die
go in with the drill from the side, you will see, because the back side will get a little bit ugly.
Machen wir da einen Strich her, so. Mal wissen, das ist ungefähr hier so die Mitte. Und dann gucken wir mal, wo man den ansetzen
muss. Search for the perfect point for the middle. So vielleicht. And then ja, it will look great afterwards.
Okay. So. Genau. Hauen wir mal da drauf. So, dann haben wir auch gleich die Markierung.
Put a piece of wood underneath, so you don't drill inside your table. For the next side, we take the first one as a guide and go exactly into the first hole and drill it out. Put something underneath again and then go for it.
Und bohren das zweite Loch durch. Wenn es wärmer ist, geht das natürlich alles ein kleines bisschen einfacher. Ach, aber mit kalten Fingern ist es sogar schwierig, den Akkuschrauber dann irgendwann mal festzuhalten. Zwei schöne Giebel.
Now we have these two parts exactly the same. So put it together, so then you can see that they are exactly the same length and that they are exactly the same appearance. And then we go to the next step.
Dann kommt jetzt als nächstes.
In the next step we take care of the roof plates. It's great that these window blinds has a little aluminum rail, so we take this as a guide that we can use it for an exact cut along this side of the blind. I think they look pretty cool, and the best thing is they are waterproof. We put it here a little bit over the edge so that we don't cut into the tabletop. When the first side of the roof is ready, then we take the other one, put them on top of it, and then we cut along so that we have two exact same pieces. And ready is piece number two. And slowly, slowly it becomes a little cool birdhouse and not an ugly one. It's time that we take these angles and connect them with the roof plates. First of all, we drill two holes into the roof plate so that we don't destroy them when we put the screw in it. So check that everything is overlapping perfectly and then put in the first screw to fix the whole thing. You have to aim perfectly so that the screw is exactly going into the middle of the piece of wood underneath it. The best tip is put your finger beneath the little piece of wood, because when you don't get into the wood, then you feel it. Start slowly, and when the screw is catching the piece of wood underneath, then you can go fast. Now the roof looks pretty finished. Now let's check if we did all the measurements correctly and put these two pieces together. Surprise, surprise! It's a little cabin for the birds.
Ist das nicht schön, ha?
Now ja, it's time for a little Bavarian snack and then we continue our work.
Kleine Ein-Mann-Portion und danach geht's weiter.
Ah, that was great. So now we have to aim very, very exactly that we get exactly into the legs of this little chair. To finish in the middle of the roof, we take a really straight branch, cut it into size and put it exactly over this little gap in the roof. And as always, first we mark it, then we cut it.
So, und dann sägt man ab.
Dann nehmen wir jetzt eine trockene Buche.
Take a dry piece of beech or a dry piece of oak or something hard, or take a piece you cut out in winter, because when you cut it out in winter, there is no water in it and you can use it immediately.
Und das ist immer ein gutes Zeichen, dass man das Brett runter getroffen hat, weil sonst wird sie da nämlich nicht so reinziehen. Und das gleiche machen wir jetzt auf der anderen Seite, da drüben noch.
And now we have a perfectly closed roof.
Geschlossenes Dach. Kleiner kurzer Zwischenstand. So schaut es jetzt aus.
That's the way it looks now. And it's getting better and better.
Jetzt suchen wir so ein paar schöne alte Bretter.
Now we look for some old pieces of wood, so that we can make a rail around the whole house. That the cats cannot enter the house and that the little birds don't fall out.
Und das gleiche.
And the same thing on the other side.
Passen wir es wieder an. Und schrauben es fest. Jetzt haben wir hier noch zwei offene Seiten.
Now we have these two sides open and to make it a little bit more Bavarian cowboy-like, we use some branches and cut the wild branches into these
gaps. Schönes Buchenrundholz. Jetzt habe ich doch noch mal einen neuen geschnitten.
So I think this one looks really wild and really cool.
Schaut euch das an, ist auch ein bisschen dicker. Das schaut gut aus. So machen wir das.
So, the last side is also finished. And now we screw it. And the cat safety border guard, however, is also ready.
So schnell geht's.
That was a fast build. A little bit of wasted material, a little bit of branches out of the garden, a little bit stuff out of the shed, and you have a very beautiful Bavarian looking birdhouse. And the birds will also love this old style much more than something new that smells like Home Depot.
Ja,
so, what should I say to finish this video? I hope you really liked it and I hope you are going to build a new old birdhouse for your garden and you should put it there maybe before the first snow, because then you get a lot of more birds in winter when it starts snowing. I hope you liked the video, so please give me thumbs up, follow my channel and don't buy crap, then you have to throw away less.